Dinosaurs.
Yes, dinosaurs. The dreadful denizens of the jungle which roamed the earth for a time period so long, it has to be measured in millions of years. Untamed, these beasts ferociously ruled our planet while we puny mammals whimpered in the corner, sometimes hiding in trees. That was until a giant meteor crashed into the earth and killed them all in one swipe. But what if it didn't? Rewind to 100 million years ago. Huge reptilian creatures walking through the wilderness, devastating everything as they pass. This famous image brings Jurassic Park to mind. Fascinating thousands of school kids around the world, dinosaurs. But real life dinosaurs weren't like the ones that you see in movies. In fact, they were fairly spread out. You wouldn't see a Diplodocus everywhere you went. Think about lions. There are thousands of them scattered throughout the world, but you don't see them everywhere you go. True, part of the reason for this is that we live in cities, but even if we didn't, chances are you wouldn't. Dinosaurs were like that. You could pretty much survive without much difficulty if you stayed out of their way. But we don't care about that. Fast forward to 65 million years ago, and a huge asteroid. Whoa, stop right there. There's a difference. A lot of people confuse asteroids with meteors. An asteroid is a random piece of rock in outer space, typically between Mars and Jupiter. A meteor is a much smaller rock which orbits around the sun and then enters the Earth's atmosphere. It comes down from space and crashes into the Earth, destroying all life. Wait, or was it volcanoes? Or wait, was it the climate fluctuating? Truth is, we're not sure what exactly killed the dinosaurs, but we can pretty much narrow it down to two theories. Here's a quick rundown. Okay, so it's called the asteroid hypothesis. Basically, everything we know about why the dinosaurs went extinct is because of a small element down there in the periodic table, iridium. Iridium is one of the rarest elements in the Earth's crust. The silvery white metal is almost as rare as gold, and a lot denser. However, it's quite common in asteroids. Rocks in the 180-kilometer wide crater called Chicxulub in Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula have the same level of iridium as asteroids and have been dated to 65 million years ago. Basically, a giant asteroid hurtled from outer space and the dinosaurs went poof. The other theory says that a large number of volcanoes erupted in India. Earth's core is quite rich in iridium, and the huge amount of lava would have increased iridium concentration on the Earth's crust. In both theories, the dinosaurs don't just die out. A huge amount of dust piles up, blocking the sun's light, lowering temperatures, and stopping photosynthesis indefinitely. Slowly, the dinosaurs go extinct. But here's an enigma. Why didn't the mammals? The Cretaceous mammals weren't like the ones we have today. These guys were small, delicate, and usually lived in burrows. These burrows prevented them from dying due to the heat wave, and when they came out, the wasteland they encountered didn't daunt them much. The mammals used to feed on tiny insects or small aquatic animals, which weren't affected by the eruption at all. Now let's say the meteor didn't crash, or the volcanoes didn't erupt. Absolutely nothing happened at all and the dinosaurs remained just as they were. What would be the case? You wouldn't find any Stegosaurus for one. Contrary to popular belief, T-Rex never munched on Stegosaurus because Stegosaurus went extinct almost 150 million years before Tyrannosaurus ever existed. That's right, Tyrannosaurus lived closer to us than it did to the Stegosaurus. Well, even if the KT extinction never happened, it would have been possible that the era of the dinosaurs was drawing to a close anyway. Cooling climates led to a harsh habitat populated mainly by forests. It was ideal conditions for mammals, but huge non-avian dinosaurs would have ended in a steady decline. We wouldn't have had much of a change. Even if dinosaurs did survive the new Paleocene epoch, they would have been wiped out at its end. The Paleocene ended with a period of extremely high temperatures known as the Paleocene, Eocene, Thermal Maximum. Extremely widely fluctuating temperatures would have undoubtedly thrown the dinosaurs off balance. Along with this was the rise of flowering plants. The years during the Mesozoic era were full of ferns which the dinosaurs fed on. But the times after that were marked with angiosperms dominating the landscape. It would be a classic case of adapt or die. But most of these events were sparked off by the KT extinction itself. If the extinction hadn't happened, then most likely none of these other events would have. We can see that there was quite a reasonable chance for dinosaurs surviving. The Paleocene was marked with a rise in rainforests. Old huge dinosaurs such as Brachiosaurus had already long gone. And the era of smaller dinosaurs was drawing underway. The size of them was steadily growing smaller and smaller. Birds would flourish. The Hootsin is the bird with claws that has developed the monkey-like skill of jumping from tree to tree. We would see a large number of these kinds of new birds around. Another event that would have had some significance was the separation of Antarctica from South America, which led to the rise of grasslands. Evolution would play its role, and then we would have, huge reptilian horses. Mammals were waiting for a chance to come out when the KT extinction happened. Before that, we had small things like possums. But it's likely that some form of primate would have evolved, which would have eventually gotten off the trees and became us. In that case, we would have lived like the Flintstones. But we would have found a way to evolve and develop anyway. In fact, it may have been completely possible to domesticate some dinosaurs. Then perhaps our development would have been crucial in their extinction, like we were for mammoths. But by far the most interesting clue comes from a late small dinosaur called Troodon. This creature had an unusually large brain capacity for any dinosaur and would have been about as smart as birds are today. Slowly, without the threat of mammals, these guys could have possibly evolved human levels of intelligence. If so, despite not having opposable thumbs, would they have been able to reach the levels we have today? Would civilization have developed 50 million years earlier? We can only speculate. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to leave a like. If you love the video, then please subscribe to my channel. And if you want to check out my previous video, click here. Thanks for watching again.